Okay, I'm going to give you just a really quick tour around my habit planner. This is an awesome tool that I like swear by. It makes such a difference for developing new habits. But first things first, when you purchase it, you're going to get a link to a Google template. And all you'll want to do is make sure that you are logged into your Google account, click make a copy, and boom, it'll open it up for you in your Google Drive. I recommend taking a minute to kind of familiarize yourself with it. Down at the bottom, you'll see three tabs: tracking, settings, and tips. Click into the tips tab and read through this. It's mostly the information that I'm going over in this video, but it's just a nice place to have it organized in case you need it. So, what we want to do first is set up what we want our habits to be and also what our goal for each habit is. So, to do that, we're going to go to the settings tab. And anything that's in here that's grayed out, I recommend not touching. Anything white, you can go ahead and adjust if you want. Power up and power down, I recommend leaving if you are one of my students and you're taking my course, Time Transformation. This comes into play throughout the course and it'll make more sense to you. If you're not taking the course, feel free to change these, but you can go in and just adjust these habits to ones that work for you. So let's say that you have a step goal of 15,000 steps instead of 10,000, that you're not really into meditating, but you're trying to read more. So we're gonna set a 15-minute reading goal. So go ahead and adjust these however you want, get them looking the way you want them to. And then when you go back to the tracking tab, you'll see that it has gone ahead and adjusted those habits in every month for the next 12 months. And then next, what we want to do is go ahead and adjust our goals for each habit. So this is not done automatically because the number of days in every month changes, so you may want to adjust it. However, we can just take like literally 1 minute to set kind of a baseline for ourselves. So you'll see right now they're all set to, if you want to do a morning water every day, that's going to be about 30 a month. If you want to hit 15,000 steps every other day, that's going to be about 15. If you want to read 15 minutes once a week, that's going to be 4 times a month. So you can go through here and just make the adjustments however you need them. Once you have it looking the way you want, just like as a baseline, go ahead and just copy those cells 5 through 14. Hit copy, and then you're going to go through each month and just control V to paste those numbers in. So you'll just go all the way down, paste them into the month so that you have those new goals set every month. And now when you go back to the settings tab, you'll see that it's updated that annual goal to reflect your change in numbers. And so to use it, what you want to do is you'll come in here, so Friday, April 1st, and you'll just want to go in and check off any of the habits you performed that day. And you'll see that the emoji changes as you go through and click. And then you'll also see over here on the right that there's also a little progress bar that shows you how close you are to reaching your goal. And that's going to change color as you progress toward it. And then you'll also see over here on the right, this red column is going to change color as you progress towards your goal. So it'll turn yellow and then eventually green, and it'll stay green even if you blow past your goal for the month. And that's also going to be tracked in an annual view. So as you go through each month and you're completing your goals, it's going to show you how many you've completed, what your goal is, and what percentage of the way you are to progress on that goal. One other quick tip is that, let's say in April, you're walking 15,000 steps, but when May comes, you want to change that to 20,000 steps. Now, obviously, you can update that in settings to 20, but maybe you want to remember that April was a 15,000 step goal. So what I recommend doing is selecting those in April, copying them, deleting them, and then pasting special values only. And now you'll see if you go in here and you adjust your goal moving forward to 20,000 steps, going to change it in all the future months, but it'll leave April as is. So I think that's pretty much the gist. That's everything you need to know to get started with the habit planner. Have fun with it.